So once again, good day, great 10 students. So we are now down with our last lesson for this week or before your examination dates. So for our fourth lesson, it will be all about the factor theorem. So tapos na tayo sa introduction ng polynomial functions. We're also done with the long division, synthetic division, as well as the remainder theorem. And now we are going to have our factor theorem. So our learning targets for this discussion, we are expected to state and illustrate the factor theorem. And lastly, we are going to use the factor theorem in conjunction with synthetic division to find factors, so correction, of a polynomial functions. So factor theorem states that if p of x is a polynomial and p of x is equal to 0, then x minus c is a factor of p of x. So ibig sabihin daw kapag in-evaluate natin yung given function and then ang remainder natin ay 0, ibig sabihin yung divisor ay factor ng given na polynomial function. And if p of x is a polynomial and x minus c is a factor of p of x, then p of c is equal to 0. Likewise or vice versa, kapag ang divisor natin ay factor ng p of x, ibig sabihin automatic na ang kanyang remainder ay, or ang p of c ay, 0. So let's have some examples for this lesson. So we are going to show that x plus 2 is a factor of x cubed plus 6x squared plus 3x minus 10. So kailangan nating mapakita na ang remainder ng functions na yan kapag dinivide ay 0. So kapag 0 yung ating remainder, automatic na factor ng given polynomial function na yan, si x plus 2. So we can use the remainder theorem or direct substitution. So we have here, p of x equal to x cubed plus 6x squared plus 3x minus 10. And the value of x is equal to negative 2. So bakit po siya naging negative 2? Kasi ang given natin ay x plus 2. And again, we have to equate it to 0. So siya ay magiging x plus 2 is equal to 0. And then, labas lang natin yung positive 2, it will be x is equal to negative 2. So dun po nang galing yung ating x is equal to negative 2. Next, substitute na natin siya. So x cubed magiging negative 2. Yung x papagdan natin ng negative 2 cube plus 6 times x. So yung x ipapagdan natin ng negative 2 cube, square, correction po, yun po ay square, plus 3x, ang x natin is negative 2 minus 10. So after natin masubstitute, again, evaluate na natin, unahin natin yung exponents. So negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2, it will give us negative 8. And then, negative 2 times, negative 2 squared will give us 6 times 4 plus 3 times negative 2 minus 10. So again, we have here negative 8 plus 6 times 4 is 24. Then 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. And then copy negative 10. So M does rule tayo, negative 8 plus 24 will give us negative positive 16. So 16 minus 6 is positive 10. Minus 10 will give us 0. So now that we have proven that p of x or the remainder is 0, so ibig sabihin, the x plus 2 ay factor pala ni x cubed plus 6x squared plus 3x minus 10. So po yung ating factor theorem. Another example or another way, so let me just erase po yung drawings. Ayan. So we can use synthetic division din po in factor theorem. So ganun pa rin po yung process. So ipuprove lang natin na ang remainder nila ay 0. So using another method by synthetic division, so we have here again, negative 2, kasi yun yung magiging value ng x, i-equate natin sa 0. And then, using synthetic division na inaral natin before, it will give us ang remainder ay 0. So same process po, then we still have the same results. Another example, so we are going to find the value of k so that the polynomial x minus 1 is factor of x cubed plus kx plus 3. So medyo iba na po yung gagawin natin dito kasi kailangan natin gawing factor ng x cubed plus kx plus 3 ang x minus 1. So we can use the remainder theorem or direct substitution. So again, what is ang given natin? We have x cubed plus kx plus 3 is equal to 0. So since x minus 1 is a factor or should be a factor of the given polynomial equation, equate po ulit natin siya sa 0. So the value of x will be, so ang given natin ay x minus 1 is equal to 0. So the value of x is equal to 1. So ibig sabihin lahat po ng variable na x ay papalitan natin ng positive 1. So we have here, x cubed will be 1 cubed plus kx or k1. So, may iwanan po yung k since wala pa tayong value ng k. So, yung ating hinahanap. Plus 3, bring down 3 is equal to 0. Then afterwards, after substituting, pwede na natin siyang evaluate. So, 1 cubed is equal to 1. Then 1 times k is equal to k. And then bring down our copy 3. Plus 3. So, after nating may evaluate, so we are going to combine like terms. So, we have 1 plus 3. Will give us positive 4, and then copy k. So k plus 4 is equal to 0, and the value of k, by equating it by 0, the value of k is equal to negative 4. So ibig sabihin, para maging factor ng ating given polynomial function ng x minus 1, dapat ang value ng k ay negative 4. So we can use synthetic division para i-prove na ang value ng k is negative 4. So by using synthetic division, we will arrive na ang kanyang remainder ay 0. Again, masasabi natin na factor ng polynomial function ng isang binomial kapag ang kanyang remainder ay 0. So that will be all for our lesson. So for our activities or for activities for this lesson, so you can check your Jenny accounts and then you have unlimited time to answer those activities. So goodbye and God bless.